That means Vasiliki Okinopoulou works as postdoc researcher in NTU, and she specialized in design and optimization of physical processes, and she will give us now an overview about the environmental performance or impact of the bioeconomy, especially on our bio case, also on our volatile case. Vasya, sorry that I couldn't Hello. Pronounce your name correctly.
Economopoulou.
Economopoulou.
It's difficult.
Okay. Okay. Bye.
Okay. Thank you, Thomas. So I'm going to present you the presentation of environmental impact of bioeconomy. And especially we'll see the application of life cycle assessment in a volatile case study. As we have, we already know, the definition of bioeconomy is that it is meant to reduce the dependence on natural resources, to transform manufacturing, to promote the sustainable production of renewable resources, and their conversion into food, feed, fiber, bio-based products, and bioenergy. The transition of the production technologies towards the optimal use of renewable resources, the reduction of pollution and the enhancement of food security is needed, but also followed by decreased the environmental impact and decreased the greenhouse gas emissions. So a key concept in bioeconomy to achieve resource efficiency is the cascading use of biomass and raw biomaterials in recycling in order to maximize the efficiency of biomass use. The biomass supply sectors provide primary material to several economic sectors such as food and feed, biomaterials, chemicals, energy. Agriculture is the biggest supply sector, providing approximately 65% of the biomass. And when talking about uses, the food and feed is the most important category that adds up to 60% of the biomass, where bioenergy and biomaterials are quite balanced, counting for 19% of the biomass. So in order to achieve a better balanced analysis of the bioeconomy, apart of course from economic aspects, environmental and ecological aspects need to be included in the overall assessment. And of course it is necessary to monitor and evaluate and forecast the environmental impacts associated with the expansion of bioeconomy sectors and the use of bio-based commodities. Life cycle assessment is an important tool that can be used in order to access these challenges and in order to ensure that the bioeconomy operates within safe ecological limits. Life cycle-based approaches provide a comprehensive structure and a robust way of assessing the environmental performance of the bio-based commodities. And the definition of life cycle assessment according to the environmental management standards ISO 14040 and 14044 is that it is a technique that among others compiles an inventory of relevant inputs and outputs and interprets the results and impact phases in relation to the objective of a specific study. The life cycle assessment, the LCA, has been recognized as a very important tool for the evaluation of environmental performance of several products, processes and services. And it is assessed by compiling an inventory of relevant energy and material inputs and environmental releases, by evaluating the potential environmental impact associated with identified input and releases, and by interpreting the results, the final results. The LCA tool helps us also to indicate the stages that have the most important environmental impact, helps to compare with standard or competing products, and contributes to the design and production of more environmentally friendly products. An LCA implementation includes 4 steps: the goal and scope definition, the life cycle inventory, the life cycle impact assessment, and finally the interpretation of the results. In the first step, in the goal and scope definition, the system is described in details and the functional unit is selected. Also, the system boundaries are defined. Different boundaries can be selected depending on the system we want to examine, such as a gate-to-gate system, a cradle-to-grave system, or a cradle-to-gate system. Of course, allocation procedures are very important, especially when we have more than one product to evaluate. Regarding the boundaries, the respective steps of a process diagram are taken into account, from material processing till the disposal or reuse and recycling of the materials. All the inputs, such as the materials, the energy or water used, are recorded. And of course, all the outputs, such as the emissions to the air, to soil, to water, and of course, the final produced products. The second step, as we saw, is the life cycle inventory. In this step, all the data that are needed for the evaluation of the economic performance are collected. The usefulness and reliability of the results depends on the quality of the data. And therefore, it is very important to define the data quality requirements, for example, where and how these data are collected, what is the quality of data that will be collected, etc. As we saw before, all materials and energy inputs and outputs to emissions to the air, soil, or water are recorded, and they are defined according to the functional unit that has been selected in the previous step. The next step is the evaluation of the result, the life cycle impact assessment, to which we identify and evaluate the amount of the potential environmental impacts that arise from the inventory phase. The input and outputs are assigned to several impact categories, and the potential impact are quantified according to characterization or normalization factors. In this table, we can see some important impact categories. For example, the global warming or climate change, the ozone depletion, the eutrophication, acidification, toxicity, etc. The final phase is the interpretation of the results. In this phase, we identify the hot spots, the processes that have the most important impact to the environment, and some recommendations are given in accordance with the that has been defined in the first step. There are many packages that are used to conduct LCA studies, as we can see in this table. GABI is the most widely used tool, and we have used it in our analysis in the Volatile project. There are several methodologies within the GABI software that are used for impact evaluation, and we have run our analysis using the RECIPE 2016 methodology. Why we're implementing an LCA? There are many reasons. The most important are for improvement of products and processes, for reducing cost of raw materials, of energy used, for harmonization with the customer requirements or ISO standards, etc. In the regarding now the bio-based commodities, LCA has databases for multiple bio-based commodities, and the databases consist of several pathways, feedstocks, covering greenhouse gas emissions and other impact categories. Due to some existing policy objectives, the database consists mostly of values referring to greenhouse gas emissions. However, there are also datasets referring to bio-based products, waste disposal routes, and food commodities, as it is seen in the figure. These are some results taken from literature for some biomass feedstocks, and we can see here the electricity footprint. The bars represent the footprint of the various biomass feedstocks, and these results are compared with the impact of fossil pathways. As we can see, most bioenergy pathways emit less greenhouse gas gases than the fossil fuels. And now moving on to our volatile case study, the life cycle assessment was applied to all the intermediate products of the volatile project, to the VFA coming from VGF or wastewater sludge, and also to the several produced bioproducts, the PHA, the single cell oil, and the omega-3 fatty acids. In this presentation, I'm going to present the results for one case of VFA production coming from VGF, and one bioproduct, we have selected the PHA case. So we defined the goal and scope of the study. As the assessment of the environmental impact of the process line used for the production of VFA or PHA. The functional unit was 1 kilo of produced product. The boundaries were defined as all the relevant life cycle stages and processes that are involved in the production of the final product. Allocation has been made based on the income that results from the selling of the final product. This means that the products with low or no value have not been assigned any impact. And the data were collected from the relevant partners of a volatile consortium, was selected from literature data or from the database of the GABI software. We collected the all data and we built our inventory. An example is given in this table. The most data were taken from industrial scale processes or were extrapolated from a pilot or lab scale. For the evaluation of the impact, we used the RECIPE 2016 methodology, as we already saw before. Moving on to the results, regarding the VFA coming from the VGF stream, we have set the process diagram. All the processes were taken into account in our analysis, the pretreatment of VGF. After the pretreatment, the liquid fraction goes to the fermenter, the produced hydrolysis gas goes to the anaerobic digestion. The liquid part is centrifuge and goes to membrane filtration in order to get the concentrated VFA. And the solid, the residue goes to AD. And of course, the water coming from the membrane filtration is recycled. The analysis was performed after taking into account the impact of VGF or not. The process was set up in Gabi, and here is the plan extracted from the Gabi software. Here we see the results, the various impact categories. The bars that are below zero have a negative impact due to the use of VGF, which is a waste. These diagrams can give us the hot spots, the processes that have the higher impact to each one of the environmental categories. And we can see from here which sensitivity analysis can be performed in order to minimize these impacts. In this diagram, we can see a percent contribution of the different processes. As we can see for this case, most of the impact comes from the energy demand and from emissions from composting and cogeneration unit for biogas production, for electricity and heat production. Interpreting the results, we saw that the higher percentage of footprint is attributed to compost and cogeneration processes. Composting has significant contributions due to the various emissions to the environment. Assuming that we use biofilters, which is a common practice in many plants, that reduce the emissions to the air, we run a sensitivity analysis and we see the respective diagram. The picture is much improved than the previous. And of course, another important issue is the use of sodium hydroxide in the fermentation process for the pH control. If we use less sodium hydroxide that is feasible in process optimization at higher scales, then the picture is much more improved than the previous one. Moving on to the PHA. Here is the diagram. We have two processes, the fermentation process for the production of raw PHA and the extraction stage for the purification of PHA. Here are again the impact categories. Fermentation has a significant impact to all, to the most of the impact categories. And here is the percent contribution of the processes. The most important impact is attributed to salt and sugar consumption. So we ran a sensitivity analysis for these cases. The effect of different sugar consumption, plus or minus 10%, has affects the most of the environmental impact, less than 4%. And the same is for salt consumption. We also compared production of VFA, of PHA using VFA platform with other methodologies used for PHA or PHB production, for example, from sugarcane, from glycerin byproducts and wastewater sludge. We know that this comparison is not totally fair. However, we performed in order to show that volatile system is comparable to other production systems. And also, if the efficiency of the certain system is increased, the perspective that is technologically feasible, then the environmental picture will be much improved. Finally, we assumed that the volatile platform was incorporated in the process line of various business cases of our consortium that treat VGF waste. And we took into account a functional unit of 1 ton per input waste. And for the analysis, we used only the impact of production, and we compared it with the production of the VFA. As we can see, the picture is good. As it expected, some environmental categories, the impact of some environmental categories, it is a little increased in our system. This is expected because new processes have been added to the process line for VFA production and recovery. And however, the picture seems feasible and attractive because the final products have higher added value than before. So, regarding our volatile project, the volatile VFA platform presents significantly lower footprint to all the categories compared to other methodologies for VFA production. The volatile pH system performs similarly with other examined systems. And the other two bioproducts, the single cell oil and omega-3 fatty acid, present also similar general environmental picture, and they are comparable to similar or existing products. The volatile technologies are new and they can be also further optimized, leading to even improved environmental behavior. Finally, the VFA platform can be a sustainable solution for the treatment of municipal solid and sludge bio-waste. And in most environmental category, the VFA platform is similarly or even better than the existing processing lines of the examined case studies. So I would like to thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Vasya, for this interesting presentation. I get already for that reason, I was a little bit delayed. I get already questions also by email related to our conference. So, are there any questions related to our environmental performance of our processes? I'm just looking in the respective part. No, I think Vasya, you did it so good that all questions were already answered before they could occur. So, okay. As I said already before, so we are also valuable during the conference more. Also, if you have further questions, you can contact Vasya, or you can also contact me, and I can also forward further questions, which maybe after one night there are appearing some more questions. We are open to answer all these questions. Vasya, thanks a lot for the presentation.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Okay, then.